Carlos, let's you and I book and go out there.
No, let's do it.
Yeah. In 2K?
You want me to come? Can I sit the back seat?
Yeah.
There is no back seat.
Perfect.
Well, I don't know what you have in mind, but you got to drive the car.
You know what? We should do the anchor challenge out there where we...
Well, who does the best? Who?
Of course I would.
Right. All right.
Do you know how to drive a standard?
Yes.
A standard? You mean a shift?
Yes, yeah, you got a shift. All paddle shifters.
Yeah. Are they all paddle shifters?
They're not on NASCAR.
They're not Ferraris.
Hey, if you want to play, all you have to do is go to KTLA.com/anchor challenge, fill out some questions, give us your password and your social security.
No,
just a little bit.
Apollo's here, would you?
Just okay, we're going to read Bruno's review of Apollo in just a second.
Oh,
but, you know,
really?
Congratulations to you. Because
thank
you're doing
you.
A really, really good job. We're going to talk all about Dancing the Stars. When you see Julianne, mm-hmm. is it a dream or is it real life?
It's the real deal.
Okay. Yeah, I'll say. That's what I was just wondering. Quick check of the Entertainment Headlines Network. Lots to talk about with Apollo. Apollo made an appearance at Wango Tango with your dance partner, not just on the red carpet there, but dancing on stage. There you are.
Jeans, yeah,
now, was this kind of a campaign appearance?
A little bit. You know, this is my first time actually Wango Tango. So when we were actually driving up, I saw all those people on the side of the hill. I was like, Julianne, check that out. Yeah, how do you feel about that? She's like, are those birds? I was like, no, that's people. Like, that's thousands of people we're about to dance in front of. And we were actually doing a dance that, you know, I basically had forgot because it's like maybe a couple, 3 or 4 weeks ago. And I don't know, it was a little nerve-wracking. But we were trying to go out there, get some support from some fans. It was fun. I had a lot of fun.
You're doing a great job on the show. And something like skating, for which you're an Olympic medalist and you can go back to Vancouver. Okay, that you do.
Right.
This you don't do.
That's what I'm, that's the thing. Is people say, well, you know what, Paul? You're an athlete, this should be easy for you, but, you know, like, skating is what I'm comfortable with. And I've been competing for, like, you know, the past 12 years of my life. And now I'm in this whole new side of my, you know, this entertainment world that I'm used to. I gotta perform, I gotta put a smile on my face, I gotta go over the top, and plus they wanna wear me some pretty funky outfits sometimes. That's a little weird, I'm not gonna lie to you, you know?
Did you ever dance before? I mean, was this completely out of your...
No.
Comfort range?
I've never danced before. You know, even if you say you danced before, here's the thing about the show. Even if you say, like, you, like, went out to, like, a club with some of your friends, like, this style of dancing is totally different. Totally different. I mean, I'm a speed skater, so, like, I'm used to being, like, crouched over in this position my whole time. Mm-hmm. But, like, you know, for instance, like a ballroom dance, you have to be, like, very, like, upright, and everything is very stiff and doesn't move. And, I don't know.
But it seems to me that being an athlete, both you and Layla, have a bit of an advantage of the physicality, right?
I think it helps just from, like, you know, because from a mental aspect, you're very used to just...
Or training discipline or something?
Yeah, like we were doing 12 hours a day a couple days this week.
Well, it shows. I mean, your dancing is terrific. I mean, it seems like they really like you, and they're really being tough on our buddy Ian. What's the deal there?
I think he's doing better. He's definitely doing better. Everybody's improving.
I like the politics of
this. Who's your rival? Who are you, like, looking over in your rearview mirror about?
You know what, with the show you have no idea, because it doesn't matter what the judges give, like, you know, the judges give you perfect scores, but the fans and people in the audience aren't voting for you. You could be going home literally like the next day. And for what I've always said is, you know what, I can only control how much training I do, how well I go out there and dance, and how well I, like, you know, excite the audience. I can't control how well Joey does or Layla or Ian.
What was your toughest dance at this point to learn to master? Was there one that you were going, you know what, this is just, isn't clicking, or did they
it's
all?
Probably all of them.
Really?
Yeah. Here's
what Bruno says about you, and I think this is so true about you and Julianne, because I think of the four, it's the best pairing. And he says, the secret is when two people move as one, and they do, which is great to watch. And you deny when we asked you if you were in love with her and or dating her. But how do you get that? I mean, I think it has to be more than, I think there has to be something personal involved.
I honestly could not tell you how you get that. I just know that from what I've learned in terms of just the pure dances,
right?
You know, you have to have that chemistry. And if that chemistry is, like, severed or it's not there 100% of the time, you're not going to be able to dance well. Yeah. And, like, when we're dancing well, like, let's say in the studio, I got to be honest with you, this is a little weird that I'm talking about this right now anyway. We're in their studio talking about dancing, and, you know. Anyway, so when we're in there dancing, and, like, if the energy is good, like, I know exactly where she's going to step. She knows where I'm going to step, even before, like, it kind of happens.
Wow.
And that's pretty cool. You know what I mean?
You have a slew of admirers. Gail Anderson, our wonderful reporter out in the field, is so in love with you.
Totally.
She literally cannot stand it.
Yeah.
And I think she's going to visually display her love.
Oh, that's so sweet.
She's going to give you a Bentley.
That's a Rolls.
Right. Wow. I mean,
wow.
I love you, Mr. Ohno.
She loves you. You know what? Gail wants to open the back seat of that big car. and avail it to the two of you.
Easy. Easy.
Wait a second. Wait a second.
Yes, she does.
See, I inspired her.
Yeah. Where is she?
She's right there.
The suicide doors.
Where is she?
She's at a car place.
Okay.
She's unlocking it. And in any event,
I have to ask you: who gave you the hardest time about deciding to do this? Skating?
This is the funny thing: is that all of my friends who were giving me all flack during the entire time, you know, when I first saw them, you know, I think we're doing this Dancing with the Stars thing, they're like, oh, you can't do that. They're actually all here now to watch the show.
Yeah. Can you get us tickets? Yeah.
Yeah. No, they're not can you. They say, we want to get out and I want to meet your partner.
Okay, so if you're not in love with her, how many of your friends are dying to hit up on her?
Like 95%.
Is there, I mean, Mario Lopez sort of talked about this last season. Is there a lot of just kind of romance on that set? Because it's all very sexy stuff. Is there a lot of romance on that set?
Sure. I mean, you're dancing with people and you're literally spending 12 hours a day with you know, the opposite sex.
Wow.
And you're like dancing. I mean, you can see some of the dances.
Yeah.
It's pretty, I don't know.
Intense.
Aggressive. Intense. But, you know, the great thing about Julianne and I's relationship is that we can keep it professional. And in that respect, you know, we can stay focused when we go out there and dance, and we still have our goals in mind. And I think that's why we've come this far.
Let me ask you about the opposite. Do you think the dancing will help your skating?
You know what? Some of the lessons, and this is just being real, some of the lessons that I've learned from being on the show in general, coming out of my shell, being able to really just like express myself and be over the top. And you know, one thing that everybody's always told me is when you go out there on stage, even if you don't feel comfortable, just to kind of own it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Just go out there and just really just like own the stage. And I think that can kind of be transferred in any area of life.
I tell you, a lot more people will be watching you on the rink now because you are a household name more than ever.
We're moving lives. We're about to send some people to Jamaica, which is kind of exciting. Do you feel good about tonight?
I feel really good about tonight.
All right.
What is the dance tonight?
Tonight is the cha-cha and the quick step. We're doing two dances, and they added an extra 30 seconds on top of each dance.
Ooh. Oh. Yeah. The quick step's that weird, that when they kick between the legs and all that kind of stuff, right?
Yeah, our quick step is pretty insane. It's fast.
Can't wait to see it.
All right.
People have been waiting not only to see Apolo, but for this. It's your chance right now to win a trip. Air Jamaica and Beaches All Inclusive Resort, thanks for the prize.
Wow,
and
we'll
give it away, I guess.
Apolo, best of luck to you.
Good luck.
It is so great having you here. We'll be watching. Okay.